Starting off tonight with Torque Brewing's Back on Track Coffee Porter, brewed locally with Railway Roasters Kenyan Caboose Coffee. Interesting. Oh wow, there is a lot of dark roast coffee in that. And still tastes a little bit of the malt behind it, but the coffee is right on top of that. Woohoo, I'm going to be up all night. So tonight, I'm going to take a look at this little GPS tracker module that I pulled out of the last mailbag. Now, I have no illusions that it's going to be a quality product, that it's even going to do what it says. And because it is such a an anonymous thing from an anonymous Chinese seller, and the manual is just, they couldn't even bother to have somebody who's ever spoken English translate this. It's pretty clearly a bad machine translation. So I don't trust this thing, and I'm not going to plug a SIM card into it because I don't want it doing whatever it does with my cellular account or any of the ones from work. So this is strictly going to be a teardown and see if it is what it claims to be. Spoiler alert, I don't think it is. In the comments of the mailbag, Ray pointed out that somebody else has done a teardown of this already and it doesn't actually have GPS capability in it, even though it specifically says GPS on it. I haven't gone and looked at that video yet, but I'm going to put a link down in the description to what it is. I didn't want to spoil the surprise for myself, and you may not want to either, but we'll just have to see what this thing is. As you may recall from the mailbag video, this thing is low inferior chip. The cost is low and the quality is not guaranteed. And that's the manufacturer's description. There's all kinds of crap like that in this manual. You can pause at various places and read it if you want. But a few things that stood out after I squinted a little bit. There is a website to access this thing and its maps and stuff. And when you're charging it, you have to have the SIM card in it. It won't charge without the SIM card in it. So I can't even power it up and see what it does. It'll also take a mini memory card, it says, which is a micro SD. Here's the specs such as they are. Charging input, AC. Yeah, no, it's not. It's a frickin' USB. Like that. It claims to have a 400 milliamp hour battery. That might be the best value in it, is taking that out. Standby time, mini TF card, video, photo. It claims to have a camera in it. Or is that about as accurate as this AC charging input? GSM GPRS. GPRS is the data format over the GSM network. So that's, I guess, reasonable. Maybe that's why they just missed a letter and that actually means GPRS. I don't know. Temperatures, humidities, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Positioning time, 25 seconds. Okay. GSM Spectrum, 850, 900, 1800, 1900. So it would work in North America if you were brave enough to put a SIM card in it. There's a bit of a troubleshooting thing there. Yeah. And where was it? Over here, it's got magnets. So you can stick it to a cart or a children's bag or an old man's pocket or a valuable bag. Should we maybe go and look at that website first? Why not? It's asking for the IMEI, which is the number off the SIM, and a password. Of course, the connection is not secure. What type would you like? Either this type or that type. Not helpful. Language. Oh, okay. It will do English. That doesn't change the options there, though. Okay. And CAPTCHA. Sure. It is an Android APK, which is the Android program package format. You can download something to your Android phone, but I am not going to even go that close to it. Like I said, I don't want my cellular account anywhere near this thing. Ah, what the hell? Let's just get into it. It doesn't look like it's got any screws on it. There is a standard SIM card, and it looks like deep in there is an SD card slot. So the two cards would just stack on top of each other. This looks like a reset button, and then there's USB. And I assume those two holes there are either the camera or the microphone, or they're just holes to let the water in when you've got it stuck to something. I don't know. It did claim to be magnetic, though, and it is magnetic, but I don't think I'd put it on a vehicle. So, a little welded seam here. Oh, no, not welded, just snapped together. Okay. Well, that was easy. Here's a magnet. Manual clearly shows two magnets. Yeah. Even in direct contact, that's not a very strong magnet. But it's a magnet nonetheless, and it's strong enough to pick up stray component leads. So I guess that can be salvaged for something. There is the battery or cell. I'm just going to snip that off. Is that this thing won't power up without a SIM card, and as I mentioned, I ain't putting one in. So there's a little shielded bit there. What is that? That looks like a little electret microphone, which may have been approximately behind one of those two holes there. Yeah, there's little holders for it. Okay. So it's at least snooping in the audio realm. Let's get that out of the way. This thing might actually be worth its weight in salvage, if nothing else. There is the board. So yeah, we have an SD card slot up there. Let me just grab one. Yep, that goes in there. So there, it looks like it's got a pinout for a camera, which it doesn't actually have on it. I'm surprised. A different version of this thing might have actually had a camera on it. Where's that thing that looked like a little reset button? Yeah, I don't see that anywhere on here, so... No, it wasn't a reset button, it was just a divot in the case. Okay. So I guess all that's left is to pry this little RF shield off here. Now, if that's an RF shield, where's the antenna? If it's going to be a cellular device, it would need an antenna. I don't see any tracks or anything on here that look like they should be an antenna. That might be a footprint for a coaxial connector. But again, not populated. Get my crappy old pair of cutters here, the ones that are buggered up anyways, and I use that as a weapon. Oh, that's not as tightly soldered down there as I had expected it to be. Okay. So that can comes off, revealing... Does it look like a footprint for a BGA type chip that isn't actually populated? Seriously? Yeah, there's nothing under there. That's completely empty. Okay. I mean, that ripped up a little bit of ground plane from there. But wow, all there is unpopulated footprints. There's not a single component on this frickin' board. Let's pull that SIM card tray off. Yeah, there's nothing hiding underneath there either. It's three connectors, a microphone, and a little lithium pouch cell. The magnet and the lithium pouch cell are the two most valuable things in there. I guess the little microphone. Well, let's see if I can put a charge into this little cell. It's not puffy at all. It's nice and firm and solid. Let's just use one of these little lithium ion charging modules to give it the best chance of success. Is there any storage charge on it? Oh yeah, it's got about just shy of 4 volts on it right now. 3.98. Okay. So it may not even be a faulty battery. So let's try it with increasing jankiness. There we go. We have a light. And We have 85, 86 milliamps going into the battery. Okay. 402, 401. So, okay, so it is taking a charge. That's good. Well, maybe that'll be at least some salvage out of this thing. Because what did I pay for this guy?
I paid the princely sum of $8.41, which is obviously more than this thing is worth, and probably more than the sum of its parts are worth. But obviously I'm going to be complaining about this. We'll see if I can get any money back out of this guy. I don't have high hopes. Well, I wonder how much a 400 milliamp hour pouch cell costs. Okay, yeah, so I mean, they're probably available cheaper elsewhere, but this is just eBay sorted by cheapest first. So, yeah, if that's all I get out of it, then it's still worth my time.
So that's a that's a really quick little video. What are we up to? 95, 96 milliamps charging current? Okay. I'll just let that do its thing for a while, and I'll sit here and watch it and drink my beer. Thanks for stopping by for probably the lamest teardown that I've ever done. I can't get over the fact that this thing does not have a single component on it. Wow. The other guy whose video Ray suggested, I'll put a link down below, he titled his video "Do Not Buy." And I'm going to have to agree. I'll waste my money, or I guess my Patreon's money, on this so that you guys don't have to. Anyways, thanks for watching. Questions or comments down below. I'll talk to you later.